everyone. Welcome back to Himalayan Mysteries. This level is called To the Starship. Now we'll start off in this big area. Follow the path around. Not much to talk about, just following the path. They come to this massive area. There's not a lot to do. This is quite a linear level. So when I come around, you find there's a part here that's higher than all the rest. You can actually use that to pull up and grab the crack in the wall. So come here, you can use the sprint button to move faster if you want. There is a grating that you can shoot. Let's use the sprint button again. Shoot out the other grating. And then I don't know why she's not doing what I'm telling her to do. Flip out of the crawl space because you don't want to be boring. Grab the bridge fuse. Then just go back the way you came. Out again. Lot flipping out. Then you wanna go for a little swim. We need two bridge fuses, by the way. If you follow this path around, you should find it that it's here. There's a door right there, maybe press the action button, she will open the door. So that's nice of her. Follow the path around again. And I come to this massive open area. Not a lot in here though, just a card. I forget what this is called. Teleport room disc. So yeah, I often forget what the items are called. I normally check and write them down, but I just keep on not doing it. So yes, this is the second to last level. Oops, I'm going the wrong way. Just swim through. And pull up and get out of the water. So what am I doing? At least we have the other side. I need to be up here. I guess I should have put it there anyway, just to refill my health. Now that's where we're going to use the disc in that room there. I want to grab this med pack, this large medi pack, first. I'm not sure if I'm going to be needing that med pack anymore, but it's good to have it. So that opened up a door, so if you can see it. That's the bin that we're going to right now. The thing in it. So let's go back around and go to that room. It's best if you get under the water than the surface, at the surface. Because for some unknown reason, lava will not swim on the surface of water. This is the door that opened. If you look through the windows over here, you'll notice that that's the room that we were just in a minute ago. Run for the beam and it's a teleporter. You can't teleport back. It's just a way to get up. So you'll notice that there are some things up there. There's also two closed doors. There was one on either side, so we're going to open them doors right now. Pull up. And you want to pull the jump switch on either side. It doesn't matter what order you pull these two switches in, because they're not timed or anything. But my finger was on the right arrow key. So, I just went for the right one first. It's just the finger that I pressed. So, pull the switch. Roll, because it cancels the animation. Let's run through here. There's a door there, which I want to point out. And now you want to be careful here. There's two, that's what I'm going to say before doing this. There's two balls. As you can see, I missed one. So I'll have to go back up and get that one. But follow through, because this is going to take you to a similar area. There's no door in this one though. Both that time. So let's come back through this one and get that other ball that we failed to get. Got it. Quickly jump back. Because the floor is going to turn into acid. Now we're going to come back with this one because the ball was dropped and gave us access to the other bridge views. So you want to exit this room and go back to this way. So we're above where we were before, as you can see. Grab this med pack and I will have a little look at this. It looks so good from up here, doesn't it? Just wanted to have a little look. So I will have time to examine the how beautiful the level looks. I'm gonna save again because this is a dive area. Do a few rolls on the way down. And basically we've got both of the bridge views here now. So So we're coming into this area where we can place them both. Place one bridge views here, and the other one here. There's only one particular spot in this level that I'm not too good at, and we're getting to that. That's gonna summon the bridge, if you couldn't tell by the name of the items. So let's come on through, over the bridge, into this area. Now this area is quite tricky. As you can probably tell. Use this ladder to get up. Drop and grab so she shimmies. Wow, shimmy. So I'm just gonna get into the crawl space, I'm not bothered. Save it here again, because this is that tricky bit. These platforms change, and you want to jump to this one, and jump. And I missed. So you want to get as far back, do a standing jump, do a running jump, turn, do a quick running jump, and do another running jump, and grab. So it's standing jump followed by two running jumps. Pull up and save again. I'll jump, wait for a second before making this jump. Oops, I waited too long. So yes, that's it, no need to wait, then jump again. And we're saved. Usually I'll wait a second for making them two jumps. This one's a little bit easier because something at the top doesn't move. I forget which side I'm supposed to be on. Okay guys, I am back. Am I on the right side or not? Well, you're about to find out. I'm on the wrong side. I call Wally. So yeah, there's another con this side. It's this side that you want to go to, I think. Yeah, this is the side. What you want to do, it's not that obvious, but it is kind of obvious. You want to run and jump to this over here. You want to grab and shimmy to the right. And then just jump on back, flip and grab and pull up. Then you want to run jump to grab this jump switch. Booby angle. Still taking a screenshot then. Well, I've already made a thumbnail. The jump back. I often mess this up. But not today, didn't mess it up. I'm gonna come into here, pull up, and yes, follow the path around. So come forward, running, jump, and grab this. Oh, don't grab it. That's the first time I've been able to make that jump without grabbing. This one you have to grab it though. For sure. Cursor on the screen, move this out of the way. I know you can't, probably can't see. There's a cursor. Propel up. To the top of this ladder. Yeah, there's a secret. Somewhere, and it's over here. You want to use this. No, it's not this one. We're not trying to be here because that actually tricks you out into thinking you have to be there. But it's much easier to come here, running, jump, and aim for the crack in the wall. Now, shimmy to the right. So, yes. That little disturbance I just had was my dog. Just so you're all aware of that. Most disturbances are from the dog. But I'm not gonna worry about the disturbances. I'm just gonna carry on as if nothing's ever happened. So, it's easy to figure out what to do when I'm disturbed. So I'm gonna come over to here. Then that edge platform over there is where we're going to go to, so run and jump, jump off it and grab. So this is just for a secret, so you, if you can't be asked to do all this platforming, you can skip it, or like a... And then you want to come down here, okay, let's just look at something. We'll come into here and you'll find an orb piece. You can combine that with the orb piece we picked up in the previous level to make an orb, which is obviously what that would make. And then you want to just come on here. This is a ladder, so you can just come down. That's where we went to get the secret. So we're back to where you want to be. And if you didn't want the secret, you can just continue on from here. So what you want to do is see that there is a surfboard. Well, would I call that a surfboard? Yeah, I'll call it a surfboard. You want to hold the action button in front of the surfboard. And see, it will surf her way down. That is pretty awesome. I've never seen it look like that. I know that it's just the zip line, but it's a surfboard. Just down here, it says danger, wear protection. And just to show you, this would happen if you walk into here. So yes. So what you want to do, so don't go in there, I just did that to demonstrate what would happen. I love how it looks like green flames, which is awesome. Pick up the explosive ammo. So we need to go get some protective clothes, which I will collect shortly. You want to move this. Onto the tile. I think it's obvious where you have to move this to, because the tile is like so different. We'll move it onto this odd looking block, and just so you can't move it off it again, it will raise slightly, so you can't move it back unless you open up this door. This is the protective clothing, so let's go and put it on, shall we? So we're going to take Lara to the changing rooms, because you can't just put it on now with us watching, because the developers would have to make an animation for it. Well, she would if we had to do that. Just to show you, this is changing the dressing room. I'm so sorry. But changing room, dressing room, same thing really. So she's going to walk into the dressing room. And she's now got the protective armour on. It's difficult to see, but if I try to get a good camera angle over, there you go. You can see that she's got it on her chest. If I look at the bottom of her feet, you can see she's got the silver stuff on her shoes, or her boots. And now we can come into here, because the protective armor will protect us. Pick up, I think that's the universal key, maybe it's still a key. Or just key disc, I'm sorry. I know one of these is the universal key disc. In fact, that might be in the next one. So when I come into here, make sure the 13 secrets. Because as soon as you come off, that door closes behind you. So yes, I quite like this level actually. It's pretty awesome. Come over to here, you'll notice that this has got a thing covering it. To lower that, you wanna pull this. I don't know if it's just me, but it sounds like there's a little whispering going on in the audio file. Sounds like a beep. Sounds like people are speaking a Belton language, like a sci-fi language, if you know what I mean. Which is weird, and you'll see why in the next video. But I guess most of the stuff here is just written in an alien language, which is quite bizarre. I guess we're in the alien parts of the game. And do I have the setting for this teleport room disc? So I'll place the teleport room disc here. I'll open up the door and turn on the teleporter. I also believe it turns on the one downstairs as well. However, we can't get to the one downstairs without doing this. This is the other side of the teleporter, so you can't go through it. So the teleporters in this game, you can go through it through one of them, but you can't go through the other one, so you may only enter through the one and you may only exit from the other one. That lever opened up the doors at the them doors. They were opened up by pulling the lever. Thank you. can see the Yarpy artifact. I think that's what it is. We've come quite a long way since the start of this. Just having a little flyby, because that's what we want. So over there is another secret. Now you can only get that secret if you have the other one in this level and the one from the previous level. And I believe you can get to the previous level if you don't have the secrets. I'm gonna pull up here. Then move around. Can see a little crack. Oopsie daisy. Where did I last save? I'll meet you guys back at the spot where I died. So I'm almost back at where I was. I think it's a good idea to give the game a good save. Careful of the slope. Don't know what I just did, like an idiot. So just shimmy to the right. And just drop. Gonna run and jump and kind of angle to the left. Just go right up here and just take you above the ship to the where you can grab at the artifact.
So, there you are. What are you exactly?
This is the is it the Athene? It's a Charter stone, I guess. I thought that would be the artifact, but the Athene. I'm gonna fall down. We will take some damage. And I don't think it's 100% necessary, but I am going to use one of my soups to cure myself. Orb. Place the orb. Pick up this. Yapni Gara. Probably saying that completely wrong. Oh well, I'm still doing a Coyote Creek. Coyote Creek. Bit of a interesting area, I guess. You now want to head to the head down to the bottom. The best way to get down is to use this slope and just grab it, fall down, grab the slope again. That's gonna put you down there. There's an alien down there. Creepy. There's a teleporter, which is gonna let us get back up when we are ready, if we get where this area is. Okay, okay. So I was just pointing the stuff out to you that aren't necessary. There's a key disc here. It doesn't work. As you can see, the door just keeps messing around. So yes. thought I forgot something from here. Yes, there is. A grating we could shoot. So I was pointing out about that, the area. I don't think it was necessary. You want to come from here. This is the nearest to an area. Just had your grating. Wow! This area. Now there's four balls, and so they will have these notches on them. You want the notches, the notches, I don't know what to call them, little knobbly bits that the are on these little balls. I'm sounding dirty, but it makes sure they are pointing at the central ball. The platform will raise when it's in the right place. If it's in the wrong place, then it won't raise. This one goes to the one on the far side. Yeah, the code disc is broken. Okay, disc. I don't know why it's not working. But never mind. We'll also be going into the area. But this is the puzzle that it would have led you to anyway, so it doesn't really matter too much. It's not this ring, but when we come up here, that's gonna open up that, but if that's there's this area. This is the area that it would have led you to. As you can see, this is the door that key card wouldn't work for. Use a spear or crowbar if you like. The door's still trying to open for us, but it won't. You can see that it's turned those platforms into slopes. That's still not doing anything for us. To get out, you want to find the core space that you went in through. We're going back to the area where we just came from. She was just, she doesn't do that awesome thing this time, but never mind. Sometimes you'll see me going out backwards to save a bit of damage. No, I didn't mean to do that. Stupid cow. Where am I? I'm all the way up here. See you guys back at the spot. So, I'm back at where I was before. Let me even got the save menu, someone to save the game. I didn't put the code in this, the card in this time, but it doesn't do anything. It just makes the door open and close. I'll jump at these slopes. I believe the last one, I know it's not. You want to grab the starship key. Now that med pack I just used was pretty pointless, to be honest. Aren't you glad that I just saved it? Because I always mess up this jump. You want to be a bit further back than you think. Then you want to jump from here to the right, looking a bit to the left with the next one. Now I need to get back up to the top. Thankfully though, there's a teleporter. Take us back to where we were. Now, we won't jump over to here. I'm going to save it. Because sometimes he doesn't grab the edge. Unless I've saved it then actually, because if you place the item here that you just picked up, the what's it called? The Japanese Starship key, that's gonna end the level, but I'm gonna do that in the next video because the cutscene, I'd rather have the cutscene at the start of the next level, so I'm gonna end it here. And I'll see you guys next time. Take it easy. Goodbye.